to a new vlog. It is Friday around noon and I'm just downtown walking around a little bit. I just picked up some lunch for myself and Dylan and I'm just waiting for him to be ready. And then I'm heading over to Aritzia in Sherway Gardens, which is a mall 15 minutes from my place. So fairly close, to shop some new fall pieces. I'm going over there because it's the opening of the store and very excited to start my fall shopping. I will take you along for this, but I'm not sure how much I'm gonna vlog of it because I'll need to do a bunch of stories and sometimes I find it hard to focus my attention on both. So I will for sure show you what I got from there. After, I also kind of want to do a sit-down video about fall pieces and my fall wardrobe, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, I thought I would just start the vlog. I am hoping to shoot my outfit and hopefully show you as well. Hey guys, I just made it to Aritzia. I'm in the private fitting room and here is everything I am going to try. Super excited to start trying on things. I've picked a lot of cashmere and knits, all in like neutral tones, a couple of vegan leather pieces that I was curious to try for a long time. I've also picked up some denim and yeah, here's the fitting room and I'm just about to start trying on. Guys, I have on some pleather pants and I think you guys are gonna love those. They're just the thing is I'm not alone here and I don't want to put my camera outside, you know, to not disturb people who are trying clothes. So I think I'm gonna show you everything once I get home, but I just wanted to give you a little sneak peek. So here's a really kind of slouchy cashmere cardigan. I don't know if it's a blend, but it's super nice and I have it in a size large so that it fits oversized. I kind of roll the sleeve like this and I love it kind of slouchy like this with this tank top. And then the pants are just such a perfect fit. Hopefully I can show you better once I'm home, but yeah, I tried them in, I just picked up my waist size and then she told me that there was different lengths, so I have the crop one and actually I don't have to alter them at all, so I'm for sure picking the pleather pants with this top so far. Just tried this dress. It's like a midi dress, I guess, but on me it's more of a maxi and this is a size small, but I think I might try a medium to get it a little bit bigger still. But it's in this really nice kind of soft melange knit with baggy puffy sleeves and I think with like higher boots this is gonna look really nice. I also like this neckline. I'm not really used to having like a V neck, but I think with a turtleneck it can look really nice if you're not too comfortable with having this much of a low cut. But I still like it right now like this as kind of a transitional style. It's also got these like slit on the side so you can see the boots in the winter and the fall. I really like this dress actually. It fits and it hangs really nicely and I like the color detail. It kind of makes it more dressed up. Back home and I wanted to show you my pieces from Aritzia since I couldn't really vlog in the fitting room. There was a family also shopping in the personal shopping fitting room, so I didn't want to, you know, film while they were trying some clothes for their daughters. I felt it was a bit inappropriate, so let me show you now. I picked up this little cashmere polo. It's got three buttons and long sleeve. It's very kind of basic, not too cropped, but also not too long. It's the perfect shape. And I got it in a size medium because it was the only size left in the store. But it actually fits really nice. And that's the one I'm planning to put underneath my Prada dress. So we'll see if that works. It works in my head, but maybe when I'm gonna try it, it's not gonna work. If not, it looks great with like everything, especially these new pants. These ones are the Melina pants in crop. I got a size 0 and the crop ones are actually perfect for my height. I'm 5'1", 5'2" on a good day, and I don't need to alter them. They're like perfectly right above my ankle, so that's really nice. These are like your perfect skinny faux leather pants. They're not too skinny starting at the knee, but I'll try them for you in another video, in a sit down video for sure. And then lastly, I picked up this cardigan, which I got in a size large because I wanted it to be oversized and wear it with denim or leggings and a turtleneck. It's just really nice. It's a different color a little bit than the cashmere. You can't really see on the camera, but the card was full. I had to delete some old footage. Anyways, it's just a V-neck basic cardigan with 2 pockets at the front and 3 buttons down the front, and very comfortable. It is a blend of mostly synthetic, but I'm gonna wear it over other things, so I don't mind that much, but maybe you will. So I'll tell you the composition of it. It's 59% nylon, 23% viscose, 10% wool, and 5% cashmere. Feels very soft though. And that's everything. That's everything I picked up at Aritzia today. And now we're just chilling some wine in the fridge and we're gonna have a nice glass of wine and maybe some sushi. It's around noon and I had a really nice morning. I went for a coffee with my friend and then I bought myself a little croissant for lunch, which I haven't ate. It's waiting for me at home. Right now I'm just downtown doing a little bit of shopping. I think I want to go to Cost, continuing on my fall shopping spree. I'm just going to the stores that I like and see what's new, and I really wanted to go to Cost. I've been wanting to go for a while, but they never had the new fall stuff, so I'm hoping that because it launched online that now they will, everything will be in store. So that's kind of the goal. And then later Dylan's gonna come back from work. He's working over the weekend again, so he's super busy these days, so hopefully we can go out and grab a bite to eat, have some wine, and have a nice evening together. I thought I would show you my outfit. I'm still wearing my Arquette top. I live in them. I'm just living in them these days. And then I have a vintage blazer. Let me put you here actually. Really hoping this won't fall. I have my Aritzia wide leg trousers with my Stella McCartney sandals and my verified handbag. Let me get further. Very simple look, but I was feeling something minimal and yet kind of cool, but not too dressy because I hate to be too dressed up to walk around on the weekend. I feel like, I don't know, it doesn't go. I'm also wearing these little blue Billy earrings, which I've really liked recently. Been really wearing them a lot more. I didn't used to wear them that much because I didn't think, I don't know, I was too lazy to change, to switch my earrings, but I've been loving them recently. I'm gonna link them in the description box, try to link everything I mentioned except the vintage pieces obviously. And yeah, that's the look for today, and let's go shopping. So guys, turns out the Coast shopping experience wasn't the best. They didn't have very much any fall stuff, so I didn't pick up anything. That's why I didn't vlog. But all good, because my friend met me and now we're having some spritz outside on a patio, trying to make the most of patio season before it's over and before fall comes. So we're just gonna enjoy our drinks and maybe walk around a little bit more this afternoon. It was a very unsuccessful shopping day. I didn't get anything. I didn't even find anything at the vintage store, or consignment store rather. And yeah, but it was really nice because I got to spend some time with my friend and we had a lovely lunch together. We had a lovely drink. The weather was so nice. It was super warm, so it was really fun. But I didn't get anything. That's why there's no footage of shopping, really. I might insert the clips anyways, but I really didn't film much because it was just not that good. So I'm back home now, just waiting for Dylan to be done with work. And in the meantime, I think I'm just gonna watch some Friends while I wait for him. I've edited a couple photos that I've taken today by myself. And I've had my eyes on my phone for so long, like looking at my phone really close, and now I feel kind of dizzy. I know looking at a TV is not better, but somehow it's not as close, and I can just have Friends in the background while I do other things, and I find that pretty cozy. So I think this is what I'm gonna do. It's around 6:30. I'm getting kind of hungry for dinner, but I don't know what I'm in the mood for. So my hair's really bad because I had it up in a pony and I've just undone it because I can't keep a tight pony like this all day, and now I have a big bump here, so I gotta redo my hair if we're going out tonight. But it seems like it's gonna rain, so I'm not sure if we're gonna be able to do a patio. If not, maybe we can go in a restaurant. I haven't really done a lot of indoor eating yet, even though places are open and everything. I just haven't really gotten to go inside and eat, so maybe tonight will be the first night. This is the croissant I got this morning and I never got to eat because I went out for lunch in the end, and now I kind of want a little bite of it because it looks really good. Dylan and I, as you probably guess, I have some eye patches on. That means we're shooting this morning. I woke up around 5:30 and I just couldn't bear to get out of bed. So now I'm out and I've got my skincare on, trying to wake up my eyes so that I don't look too puffy when I shoot. We are shooting something with, I'm sorry if you can hear the call. We're shooting something with Dior, which I'm so excited about. I'm excited for you guys to see it. Hopefully it will turn out the way I envision it in my head. But yeah, very exciting shoot this morning. And we wanted to catch some great light, so that's why we're so early. So I'm just gonna make my coffee, get myself ready, go wake Dylan up, and then we're gonna pack the coffee and go. It is much later. It's around 5 p.m. I am showered and I've done my skincare. I took a shower early because I put quite a bit of makeup on for the shoot this morning, and it was so hot today that I just felt like I really wanted to wash my face. So I took an early bath. It was really nice. I made a really nice bath and very relaxing. And yeah, today I spent the day editing my photos for Dior. I'm so happy with the shoot. Everything went so smoothly this morning and I'm really, really happy with the results. So I can't wait for you to see it on my Instagram. Yeah, it's one of those shoots that I have too many photos to post and I can't pick any because I like most of them. And yeah, it's really, really nice when that happens. And whenever that happens, it kind of gives me a little push to keep going. But anyways, I'm just wearing my Uniqlo. This one is a men's t-shirt, long sleeve, and it's just very boxy. It's got a little pocket. I really like it for around the house. It's really comfortable. And then I have some lounge pants from Aritzia. Very, very loungy outfit. But I wanted to talk to you about couple products that I really have been loving and that I've just used on my face. I've been sent this moisturizer by Chanel after I did a private consultation with their skincare specialist. She recommended a couple of products that would be best suited for my skin type and my skin needs, and she recommended two key products that I should use, and she was right. I love those products. They completely changed the way my skin looks. My skin is way less flaky. Not that it was flaky before, but here I used to be a lot more dry and it would be hard to apply makeup here because it would always kind of cake by the end of the day and underneath my eyes. Even if I did all of the hyaluronic acid serums and like I exfoliated and all of that, I always felt like my skin really needed something richer, and this moisturizer is insane. It is so rich, so moisturizing. If you have dry skin, I would highly recommend it. It's the Hydra Beauty Nutrition Moisturizer for dry skin, and it is very rich, very thick, but it leaves your skin feeling really nice. It's not too heavy. For example, today is like over 30 degrees outside and I don't have AC on at all time, and it's really hot and I don't feel like, you know, I have something really thick on my face. So if you're looking for something, even for the winter or the fall, I would highly recommend. This is my favorite Chanel moisturizer, which is a huge statement because I love a lot of their moisturizer. And then alongside the moisturizer, she recommended I use an oil cleanser. So I've never used an oil cleanser before. I've always only used gels or milks, but I've never used an oil and I was really curious to try it. This one is L'Huile Anti-Pollution Cleansing Oil, and it's an oil that turns into a milk when it's in contact with water. So it's not, like, it glides really well in the face and it has the texture of an oil. It feels like an oil, you know, very smooth and very, you know, it glides very well, but it doesn't leave your skin oily, which is really, really good. I've been using it once a day. I use the CeraVe cleanser in the morning, and then at night I like to break down my makeup with this one, and it's been amazing. My skin is so smooth. I haven't had any breakouts in so long except for this one. This is kind of like a scar that's gonna go away eventually. But yeah, my skin has been very clear, very even, and I think it's partially because I've introduced these two steps in my skincare routine. Right now, I think I'm just gonna go and watch a little bit of videos. I worked pretty much all my Sunday, so I think I'm just going to go and relax, and tonight we're gonna go have dinner at Dylan's parents, so I'm excited to eat some nice home-cooked food. And I think I'm gonna end the vlog right now, actually, because I'm not sure I'm gonna pick up my camera. I don't usually pick up my camera when I'm over there, so And yeah, I'm not sure what this vlog is gonna look like. I can't remember what I filmed. Hopefully there will be enough footage to make it a vlog and I don't have to skip a week again. But yeah, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching. Thank you always for leaving such lovely comments under the vlog. I read all of them and it always makes me smile. And I hope to see you in my next video. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe. It would mean a lot if you would come back for a next video and you'd be a subscriber. So yeah, I love you guys and I hope to see you very soon. Bye.